Metropolitan International University, and of course every day here on Rush Hour, we between 9 and 10 is the Rush Talk. Definitely looking at what is happening and what's going on, of course, in our country every day. But before I go any further, kindly join us on our socials. Our Facebook is, of course, Urban TV, Uganda, Twitter. You can join the discussion conversation. Hashtag is Rush Talk, Urban TV Uganda. And of course, you can be able to join us. With me is my big brother, Patrick Kaboyo, who is an educationist, as well as, you know, so many other things there. But we know him as an educationist. Good to see you, my brother.
Thank you, my brother Miles, and happy to be here. And thank you for the work you do for this country.
Thank you so much. We don't have that much time, and yet there are so many things I want you to tell us. But first thing first, we, as an educationist, we have so many things happening in this country where we've seen recent having artists going to, you know, schools dressed indecently, all skimpy. Others are using vulgar, probably songs. How do they get into the schools with this skimpy or indecent dress code?
Thank you, Miles and viewers. To start is that our education construction, specifically schools,
yes, sir,
is twofold. One, there are those things that you will know as a parent,
okay,
and there are those you will never know until you bother to find out. Reason being that communication...
What do you mean, bother? You mean it once you get into it, maybe you get actively involved in it?
Yes. Bother is if you have a son or daughter who studies somewhere in a school, normally when they return, you don't have time to sit them down to ask how school has been, what happened, or a review.
Okay.
That's the bother. They will be able to share with you, you know, daddy or mommy, at school there were about 20 students who had these issues, then you understand. So some artists are old boys and old girls of respective schools where they go.
Okay.
Before COVID-19, the acronym SOP, or Standard Operating Procedure,
yes,
was not common in our vocabulary.
Mm-hmm.
But every school has operating procedures that set standards.
Surely, yes, surely, yes.
If you visit some public schools of recent, you will find them with a poster on at the gate listing how you should be dressed as you enter.
Yes, for parents.
For parents.
Yes.
Yes, but for that's for parents.
Adults, or should you say adults or parents?
Parents.
Okay.
Because we know that when we are enforcing morality, we look at five institutions. The first, we look at family. We look at the religious leaders. You can call them churches or mosques.
Mm-hmm.
We look at government. We also look at institutions where we work, and then we look at education institutions. So an education institution should not purport to play the role of government or the role of a religious leader. So issues of morality, yes, are paramount, but are akin to religious experts. But of course, schools teach learners to know right from wrong, and we cannot legislate morality purely to bar these artists from entering schools the way how they are dressed, for three reasons. One, that art is a science. It has standards that it follows for it to be performed and appreciated.
Yes.
One of those is costume. And it's not costume
code,
but it should be the right costume.
Maybe a culture.
Of course, cultural institutions were part of the other five entities I talked about.
Okay.
So you cannot change culture because you want to legislate. Of course, in the art, as in music or drama, there is also an embedded culture.
Yes.
That, for instance, if you are presenting a La Raka Raka dance or Orunyege,
yes,
you will not wear a gomesi to dance Orunyege. You will fall.
Oh, yes.
So that is a standard.
Yes, sir.
Equally, when a musician is approaching a school gate to present, I don't think this artist will leave her car because it normally denotes the other gender. Because society seems to be aggressed in terms of how ladies are dressed. It is prudent that the lady artist wears her costume as she goes to the stage. After the stage, she can wear normally. Because musical art has a culture of costume, which is a standard, and you cannot change it.
Yeah, Mr. Kawiyo, however, sorry to interrupt you, though. If you say, like, okay, I'm a female artist, and I am going to dress what I feel appeals to my kind of target audience, don't you think it's something that we ought to, especially a musician, ought to know or to do, that it is not about the dress code, it's about the message that comes in my head? We have a couple of artists, I'm sure you know them here. They dress decently. I mean, you've seen quite many, some other gospel artists, others. But you see, it is, I think, in the artist mentality that if I dress skimpy, short things, I appeal more. Is that the case?
The case here is that for an artist to present herself on the stage, there has to be a known brand.
Okay.
But this brand has to be agreed by the person who has invited the artist to the school.
Oh, first, the person who invites.
Invites.
They should, you know.
They should know the brand.
They should come in. Oh, the brand.
Yes.
Okay.
Because if you are a school X, you are inviting artist Z, you know that this artist is like this. You ask, is it the right audience that this artist is coming to perform to? Yes. Is it the right costume that this artist is going to wear? Yes or no? And if the costume is not right, then you look at the audience, you look at the message, you look at the artist. But by and large, schools are not so much bothered by that. What bothers schools now is the type of songs that have some messages that are not age appropriate.
They
don't appeal. Some have vulgarities in them. But also the other issue that the promoter of this topic ought to have looked at first are the key pressing issues in schools and not the artists. The artists are at the peripheral. There are small issues we'd want to discuss via schools. What we need to discuss is Miles Ruamiti's son, who takes sweets to a school X, wants to become head boy, and my son cannot afford sweets. You find the whole class P4 B or A has sweets from male son. And that undermines confidence, self-esteem, and leadership. The other issue that the promoter of this topic would have thought about would have been the rampant cheating of examinations. That if learners really don't earn the marks they are supposed to earn in school, that if parents connive with teachers and learners to solicit for money, to give, to influence marks which are not genuine, we shall end up with doctors or surgeons who cannot operate our patients.
Yes.
Because they didn't pass. So that should be the focus where the Honorable Member of Parliament ought to have brought as key issues.
Yes.
But these artists,
just to go a little bit for the artists, sir. You mentioned a very, very a strong point right there.
Yes.
I like the submission of who, why should kids, maybe they're campaigning,
yes,
or they are trying to be leaders,
yes,
why should they go ahead and actually bribe, buy sweets, buy, I don't know, chocolates, and they give in the school. There are those, actually, I've seen in the papers, in the press recently, all over the media, where some schools' kids go with big cars. Others even take artists. And this is a level of primary.
In fact, we need a very big hand of regulation from government to make sure that schools become schools and not showbiz.
Yes.
Schools become schools and not something else. Because in terms of having a student, invite an artist to perform,
mm.
it might not be so wrong because this artist might be a big brother or a big sister of this student.
No, but that also, me, okay, he's a big brother, a big sister to a young kid. But now me, I don't have, like me, another kid doesn't have a musician or who is, you know, a brother who's a musician.
If the school deems it good enough that the artist can entertain based on the theme for which the elections or school prefects are being elected for, it can be good. But it should not attract any monetary benefit or it should not sway these young souls from voting my son, because Miles is everything in Uganda's entertainment industry, as we know. And you'll find that your son can even be elected by mayor mentioning Mr. Ramiti's son.
Yes,
you
yes.
have our votes.
Yes, yes.
But imagine if your son brings Chameleon to the school, my son will never compete.
But again, someone will argue
yes.
that, you know, these are the future leaders. Where are they going? These are things that are done. Why don't they start from the early stage?
In fact, this country has 10 national ethical values.
10?
10.
Non-ethical?
Ethical.
Oh, ethical. Okay.
Ethical values.
Okay.
National ethical values.
Okay.
But the sixth one is on creativity and innovation. When our fathers and grandparents who are in leadership now, you hear them call us Bazukuru.
Yes,
but
true.
Some of us are beyond that age.
When
sometimes they sit in boardrooms, they frame policies and put things there which do not resonate with the age group at the moment.
Yes.
Things which should be planned for your children and my children are so different from those that were planned 10 years ago, because
yes.
things are changing.
Yes, yes, true.
Yes, so what we have to do here is to encompass this conversation by looking at television. You know that most of our children in our homes are accustomed to watching TV. Even when you are not there, you will find that they are watching things you are not aware of.
Yeah.
Practical things that they attach. There's a saying which goes that when I see, I will remember.
When you see, remember.
Yes, you remember. The picture is painted directly. Children are seeing those kissing, are seeing those caressing,
yes, yes.
are seeing those playing funny things. And
the bad language.
Yes. Are you aware that studies have shown that children of P2, P1, are having sex?
No, I am not aware.
The reports are there, and if this lands into your ears, it becomes strange, but you also get to ask, is this really happening? Those who are watching us know that this is happening. It's not happening that artists have gone to schools with skimpy dresses. No. It's because the TVs have also not been regulated to ensure that parental guidance. Yes,
we have moved away from, you know, we used to have gossip around 7:30 there, so there's now that watershed until up to when the kids are sleeping at 11. But if my son likes, okay, this small artist, that boy,
the fresh kid, yes,
and fresh kid is gonna turn up to school, it's a kid's day, and fresh kid is gonna come turn up school when he's dressed in, you know, those swag fashion for stars.
Yes.
Now, my son, the fact that they look like they're the same age, regardless, you say, oh, this is my superstar. I want to dress like him.
Oh.
I want to look like him.
Mr. Ramiti, if your son dares make such a statement, it means that Miles has not inspired this son. The first person to inspire your children should be you, the parent.
Okay.
So if this son looks out for other role models, it means that there has been no discussion.
There's a big gap.
There's a big gap.
Okay.
So I dare you need to have this son converse with you and ask him, why do you want to be like Fresh Kid?
Mm.
And if it's about clothing, you can have the clothing line brought home. But then you could ask, what is it that Fresh Kid does that you can't do? Do you think you can be better than him? Mm. Your son can easily tell you, by the way, I beat him in class. I beat him in algebra. I beat him in this. Mm. Then you say, yes, you can be better than that.
Okay.
That's what I think.
Yeah, a good one. Interesting, Mr. Kabayo there. But yes, still going back to, you know, indecent dress code from especially musicians. Yes, as much as you want to blame the school, but don't you think it's also discipline in a way by these artists to know that when I'm going to a school, maybe it's a secondary school, there will be kids, you know, and I dress my trousers while, you know how they dress the jeans,
yes,
are falling down. The you know, of course, other things, the shirts, others that have not even, you know, dressed decently. Don't you think in a way a musician should know that, hey, I'm going to a school and these are kids. They look up to us. We are role models, maybe we are their stars. What we are doing, they want to do these things in future. Can't it start with them?
Miles, it's good. I think you are the first to open this conversation openly, nationally.
Thank you.
I should tell you that it is a tall order for you to legislate morality.
Mm.
And in law, you will be asked, what is the intention? What's the purpose for this indecency? You cannot separate artist standards from costumes, which are red costumes according to their production. In schools right now, learners are taught about five senses, you know, taste, touch, feel. But we also have to put an auxiliary sense of common sense. Common sense will tell this artist that if I'm going to a school X, let me bother to find out the history about this school. What are the do's and don'ts of this school? You understand the client before you go to perform. And if you know that this school has a religious background, for God's sake, you will have to put your right costume aside and wear the appropriate costume according to the school. So if that is done, then there will be no discussion with the artist being dressed skimply. But also, school should go ahead and enforce school rules and regulations to be known. If in this sense, in terms of dressing, is one of them,
mm-hmm,
the artist should not know.
Yeah, exactly.
So that they are not caught unawares. They should be able to know that if, for instance, I'm meeting Miles Ruamiti,
yes, sir,
I should be dressed smartly because we watch you smartly dressed
on television. Thank you.
And you should have a decorum or the language, because the way you behave as an artist in a school should not be the way you behave as an artist at Chadondo rugby ground.
Exactly.
Yes, you have to.
Yes. But still, Mr. Kawi also, I've seen, you know, like, some sort of on their notice boards, you know, at the entrance of the schools, most of them, by the way, where they say, check your dress code. This is not allowed here. You understand what I'm saying?
Some you won't enter.
Exactly.
Yes.
Now, but don't you also, some teachers, don't you think also they dress in a manner that is not really appropriate?
No, gone are the days when, of course, I want to tell you, males and viewers, that what we are discussing resonates to the national schooling system.
Yes, yes, yes.
But when we bring in the international schooling system,
how different are they? And those ones?
Those ones, I don't want to go there because I have taught in an international school.
Oh, you have?
Yes, and you'll find that this discussion, for example, won't hold water there, because you are having parents from all walks of life, from UK, yeah, from Japan. Imagine a parent got communication from the school that on the 31st will be the visitation. She flies from New York coming to visit this child, and she's from New York dressed as the New Yorkers. As soon as she lands on your gate, you bring in your issues of indecency. Now, there, of course, it can't work. But for the national conscience, this is critical, but to really emphasize that there should be rational thinking within artists and school leaders to tell right from wrong and wrong from right.
Yes, yes.
So that morality is enforced not by a matter of law or legislation, by common sense.
Okay.
Because if your trouser is almost falling, you will see that if somebody touches it, it will fall. If your part of the belly or the bottom is seen, nobody is interested in having your bottom seen. But if there are those areas that will go and meet a certain class of client or clientele, and they are happy with that, of course that will not be a school. But a school has an education setting that has known standards, do's and don'ts. But however, schools should not bend to thinking that they will regulate costumes. There are swimming pools, you know that. These learners go to swim. So shall we have the same moral yardstick applied to the swimming pool that no. You must swim in a dress, you must swim in a very long, how will you flap the water? So every artist must know that there are standards that should apply.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes.
It's common sense for me. And you've seen, even by the way, you're talking about female artists, but even male artists who actually dress funny, you know, shirts, they walk in there, like we said, their pants are almost falling off. I think you know what? Most of them are even parents.
Yes.
They are
true,
parents.
True.
So just imagine if your kid, maybe they don't mind, your kid is exposed to this kind of thing when, you know, you don't even mind. And you see, Mr. Kawaya, sorry to take you back. Have you seen these awards?
In like, Uganda?
Like, no, not even Uganda, but the foreign awards, maybe.
Yes.
BET, Grammys, yes. MTV. Look at the way some of these guys dress. Very smart.
I want to make you laugh, yes, and the viewers laugh. When, yes, we were still in high school, they used to say that beautiful girls will always fall and take the bad boys. Those who don't shower, those who are not groomed.
Is it true? Does it happen like that?
You can reflect when you are in high school.
I am trying to get the narrative there. But you know, somehow you're right.
I want to link it to the BET.
Okay.
Internationally, artists have picked the bad to represent the good. And if you find somebody is not well groomed and has issues that you really see are negative, we'll move with them up to the international level. Because he is at the international arena, somebody in Uganda who is upcoming will pick that without research or without censure. So there should be a component of research. Let these artists in Uganda, for instance, if you ask fresh kid, who is that artist you are looking up to? He can tell you an artist in the UK or in the US.
True.
But the right guidance to fresh kids should be that he should be guided to read more about this artist. What made this artist what he is?
What is his background?
How did he grow up? How has he matured?
Our culture here,
exactly.
People don't read.
In fact, they call it profiling. Because if I watch you for a long time, I follow you as your follower, I should be able to adapt your style and replicate it. Oftentimes you have seen CEOs having subordinates or line managers who speak like them. When you send your staff to a meeting and he begins presenting, you will say, oh, this sounds like Don Wanyama, because he has emulated him and has tried to do exactly like him. But let our children not copy artists for the sake without knowing deeper information about these artists.
It is something I'm thinking through, that if you have this, you know, I want to be like this artist, but then also you all you know is about a song.
Yes.
Nothing else. Maybe are these people into business?
Yes.
Do they do other things after, if not music? How do they, it's very actually important.
In fact, the why question. Why should I be like you? Why?
Okay, impact way to jingambirege.
Amot.
Hey, amot chari.
Yes, I pull.
I go. Now, you know our time, sir.
Yes. Which is very short.
Very, 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 very. But we're to ganira. Next time to jam, we jagaru kakandati. So your final words, sir?
My final word is,
can reach you.
First of all, to thank you, Miles, for this program. I think this is the beginning.
Yes, sir.
Can we expand it?
Yes, sir.
And have more discussion on this?
Yes, yes, yes.
But also to guarantee that schools are not going to regulate artists' costume, because those are standards. But we shall not allow the bad things to happen in schools.
Yeah.
We shall use rational thinking and common sense to do the right thing. And going forward, we want art to be considered as a serious component of teaching and learning processes in our Ugandan schools. Because in schools, as we speak, protocol has changed. People, when you go to, they address you as your head teacher, Mezru Amitha will say, teachers of science, the head teacher, the deputy, ladies and gentlemen. So that should be changed. Yeah.
Interesting there. So is there any way we can, maybe if we're looking for you, people are watching you all over the country, they would probably contact you, anything like that?
Yes. On Twitter, at Patrick Kaboyo. I also have my contact, which is 0772-594028. And I also have an email address, pmkaboyo@gmail.com.
So you are only on Twitter, you are not on other socials?
On others, I have handlers who help me. Yes.
It's crazy.
Yes.
Okay, thanks so much. Of course, this has been the Rush Talk. That brief, we are going to go through straight to our, you know, PDM, of course, with different guests coming through. We'll be talking about, of course, as we all know about the PDMs, what's happening here, there. So let's have a great, you know, a lengthy interview with our people there coming through in a few minutes from now. But hey, don't forget that every day, the Rush Hour, it is from 9 o'clock to 10 in the morning. And of course, you know, our other programs that come through as well as we can. But this is my brother here, Kaboyo. We'll definitely bring him back. We're so sorry about time, but next time we shall be with you, sir, here, and have a great day.
Looking forward.
Thanks so much, sir.
Most
have a great
welcome.
Day and bye-bye.